Only on 7 News, conflict and controversy surrounding the nation's number one selling birth control pill. Its maker says it's safe. But Call 7 investigator Tony Kowaleski discovered a growing list of women here and across the country claiming Yaz and Yasmin put their lives in danger.
If I tried to inhale, I was just gasping for air.
She's a working mother with 4 children.
It was very scary. I think it was close to the point of probably lung collapse or death.
And she's a college basketball coach. They both spent more than a week in the hospital with potentially fatal blood clots in their lungs.
The next day, they had asked me if I was on birth control, and I told them Yaz, and they said, you will not take that anymore.
When I told them that I was on Yaz, they said I needed to stop it immediately.
Both women blame their birth control pill.
But there's one pill that goes beyond the rest. It's Yaz, the pill more and more women are turning to.
Yaz is the number one selling birth control in the country, boosted by a trendy, aggressive marketing campaign.
Have you heard about Yasmin?
Yasmin. The Yasmin low-dose pill is the number one brand of birth control pill in the U.S.
Dozens of Colorado women and more than 1,500 women nationwide are suing Bayor, the maker of Yaz and its predecessor Yasmin. They believe the chemical makeup of the pill caused their blood clots.
You know, I try to stay healthy, but I just keep getting sick. I mean, I've had several ER visits after the whole experience.
The most recent figures available from the Food and Drug Administration show more than 1,700 reported cases of blood clots connected to Yaz and Yasmin, including pulmonary embolism and deep vein thrombosis.
Talk to your healthcare professional and find out if Yaz is right for you.
To help answer that question and others, the FDA is currently testing Yaz and other birth control pills. It has recently forced Bayor to change the contents of its label and correct misperceptions created in some of its commercials.
You may have seen some Yaz commercials recently that were not clear. The FDA wants us to correct a few points in those ads.
If I would have known that whatever I was putting in my body was that, you know, causing that kind of harm, I would certainly have stopped.
Bayor declined a 7 News request to respond on camera to the accusations made in the lawsuits. Instead, the company sent this email saying in part, Bayor stands behind the safety of its oral contraceptives. The lawsuits filed by plaintiffs focus on side effects warned about in labeling for Yaz and Yasmin.
Serious risks include blood clots, stroke, and heart attack.
The company also wrote, Bayor will defend itself vigorously against these lawsuits.
This product is one of Bayor's largest profit centers, and they're going to fight to the very end.
Michael Berg is one of 3 lead attorneys nationwide representing women suing Bayor.
I've done this long enough to know when a company is going to protect their product, regardless of what kind of damage it's doing to the public.
Pastor, it's just the ER visits. Not being able to do things with my kids or my friends, it's just, I just think it really affected my body a lot.
Now, there are conflicting studies on the safety of Yaz and Yasmin. Some say the two present significantly increased risk, while Bayor says its testing concluded there is no greater risk with its product. Now, both women profiled in our report advise everyone to ask more questions of their doctors and do more research before deciding on a specific birth control product. Now, attorney Michael Berg tells us that he anticipates at least a 2-year legal battle with Bayor before they have a decision.
But you're right, we all should be reading that fine print.
All medication.
Yeah, you're right.